Hey everyone. The iPhone 13 has been showcased in various social media accounts of Apple, and they will be available for sale in the upcoming days. Now, I've been using an iPhone 11 since 2019. Being an Android user all my life, this was my port of entry to the iOS ecosystem. While I do have my own share of complaints with iOS, we're not here to take part of the endless Apple versus Android debate. I transitioned to iOS because the iPhone 11 at the time could shoot the best video I specifically wanted for my travel, food, and tech vlogs, even though I haven't uploaded or edited most of them yet. I just didn't like the video cameras from Android at the time. The Samsung Galaxy S10, the Xiaomi Mi 9, and even the Huawei Mate 30. The iPhone 11 just had wider camera lenses, both front and back, a wider depth of field, and it can shoot videos better in low light. Anyway, ever since the Apple livestream, I've been endlessly racking my brain whether I should upgrade or not, and if I will buy one, which iPhone 13 would be the best to get. So, I made a simplified list of all the differences of all the iPhone 13 models to help me, and maybe help you as well, if you're in the same situation, decide what's the best phone for us. While the iPhone 13 was able to get good upgrades versus previous generations, same and similar features between the four models will not be mentioned here. We will focus only on their differences from one another. If you want to see the full specs, you can go visit the official Apple website. Let's start. From small to big, left to right, we have the 13 mini, the standard 13, the 13 Pro, and the 13 Pro Max. Note that the 13 mini and standard 13 are exactly the same phone in terms of features. They are different only in size, weight, and battery capacity. Same goes for the 13 Pro and the 13 Pro Max. Here's a detailed chart, so you can just pause if you want to read. Basically, the bigger the phone, the heavier it is, but also the better the battery performance. In terms of battery life, Apple claims the 13 mini can continuously stream video for 17 hours straight, 19 hours for the standard 13, 22 hours for the 13 Pro, and 28 hours for the 13 Pro Max. And in a recent video by Mr. Who's the Boss, he recorded the process of draining the batteries of each model through heavy usage with everything maxed out, of which the 13 mini lasted 6.43 hours, the standard 13 7.75 hours, the 13 Pro 8.28 hours, and the 13 Pro Max held out for almost 10 hours. From here on out, we'll be combining the 13 mini and the standard 13 into what we'll be calling the non-Pro. For the 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max, we will be calling them just Pro, because again, they're exactly the same phones with the same features. For storage capacity, the non-Pro can only go up from 128GB up to 512GB. The Pro models have a 1TB option. This is speculated to have been made for the huge file size of the ProRes format videos the Pro iPhone 13s are capable of. For display, the non-Pro has the usual 60Hz refresh rate, while the Pro has what we call the all-new ProMotion feature, where it's not just 120Hz, but it's adaptive 120Hz. It automatically adjusts between 10 to 120Hz depending on the content you are viewing. This tech would be very useful in saving battery life. Max brightness for the non-Pro is 800 nits, while the Pro has 1000 nits, which makes it a bit more viewable under strong daylight. Not a world of a difference, but still. For the A15 Bionic chip, each variant pretty much has the same computing power. Just that, the Pro variants have one extra GPU core for the gamers and creatives out there. Mr. Who's the Boss did a metal test on Geekbench, and the Pro variants performed almost 50% better. Now this obviously won't scale in a real-world scenario all the time, but at least we have that one metric down. Better wait for other YouTubers to do more benchmarks for actual results. Let's move on to cameras. The non-Pro kind of loses out here a bit. The non-Pro doesn't have a telephoto lens, so it doesn't have optical zoom up to 3x like the Pro does, and the non-Pro only has 5x digital zoom instead of 15x on the Pro. The Pro has an f1.5 wide and f1.8 ultra-wide aperture, which means it can take in more light, therefore having brighter photos and videos than what the non-Pro can capture on its f1.6 wide and f2.4 ultra-wide apertures. Also, the non-pro's portrait mode doesn't have night mode like the pro does, so you won't be able to simultaneously blur your backgrounds and brighten them when in dark environments. Kind of a bummer. The pro can shoot in Apple Pro RAW, while the non-pro cannot. Basically, Apple Pro RAW is Apple's RAW file format that professional photographers and editors use in their workflow. If you don't know what that is, then you probably don't need it. The Pro also has a macro mode on its ultra-wide lens, while the non-pro does not. For video recording, pretty much the same with our previous camera category. The non-pro doesn't have optical zoom and only has 3x digital zoom, while the pro, with its telephoto lens, has 3x optical zoom and 9x digital zoom. Apple also gave the pro phones the capability to shoot video in ProRes format. It's basically similar to Apple Pro RAW, but in video. This is for the professional videographers out there. Note that the 128GB variants of the Pro can only shoot ProRes in 1080p 30. Those with bigger storage can shoot at 4K 30. Something to keep in mind. Like the previous iPhone 12, the Pro variants have this extra sensor called the LiDAR scanner. LiDAR meaning light detection and ranging. It measures how long it takes for light to reflect back from objects, essentially creating a depth map of your surroundings. This can help greatly in camera focus, especially in dark environments. LiDAR is also used by various apps for augmented reality. Lastly, we have the pricing. I'll only be including the 128GB base price for each model, as those with bigger storage will be up to the user if they want to spend more. The iPhone 13 mini costs $700 in the US and 45,000 pesos here in the Philippines, $800 and 51,000 pesos for the standard 13, $1,000 and 64,000 pesos for the 13 Pro, and $1,100 and 71,000 pesos for the 13 Pro Max. Is the 100 bucks or 5,000 pesos price increase worth it for the extra screen real estate? Or is the $200 or 10,000 pesos price increase worth it for the added features of the 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max? I cannot say for sure myself, but it would most definitely depend per person based on what they want and need. So there you have it. I hope I was able to help you in some way. And if you're getting an iPhone 13, which one would it be? Which one would be worth it for you? I'd love to hear your thoughts, so comment them down below. Personally, I am leaning on getting the 13 mini or the 13 Pro on the basis that if I'm upgrading, it's either I spend the least amount of money by buying the cheapest model, or if I'm spending anyway, might as well get the one with the most features. I know, deep inside, that I will be able to use that telephoto lens. After all is said and done, I'm still not decided. I might not even buy one at all since my iPhone 11 is still working perfectly. This is still a decent enough rig to shoot photos and videos when it comes to YouTube vlogs. I guess we'll see in the upcoming days. And if I get one, expect that I'll be making videos about the iPhone 13. So make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon so you won't miss the updates. Alright, that's it for today. This is Chad and thanks for watching.